Hi, I'm Dr. Nikita Dhakal, and I'm working as a consultant at Dr. Rita Bakshi's clinic in International Fertility Center, New Delhi. Today we're going to talk about a little bit about blocked fallopian tubes. So before starting about the blocked fallopian tubes, I would like to talk about what are actually fallopian tubes. Fallopian tubes are organs that connect the uterus to the ovaries, and they transfer the ova from the ovaries to the uterus. So, and if we have a blocked fallopian tube, then the patient will come to you with infertility. So what are the effects of blocked fallopian tubes in fertility? It is one of the most common cause of infertility, and it consists of about around 25% of patients. They will come to us complaining of infertility. So what are the causes? It could be due to any kind of uterine infection, mostly pelvic inflammatory diseases or sexually transmitted diseases. Two most common ones are chlamydia and gonorrhea, or you could also have blocked fallopian tubes after any pelvic surgeries. It could cause the tubes could get adherent to any organs like the uterus or the ovaries. And how do you diagnose it? How do we diagnose it? It could be diagnosed by HSG, that is an X-ray done to see the tubes. What we do in HSG is we insert dye from your uterus through a catheter, and if we see spillage through the tubes in the pelvic cavity, then we say that the tubes are not blocked. But if we do not see spillage, it could be either the spillage could be present either in one side or none of the side, then we say it's either unilateral block or bilateral block of the blockage of the tubes. Otherwise, another way to diagnose it, a confirmatory diagnosis, is by surgery, laparoscopic surgery, in which the tubes can be seen as blocked tubes. And what can be done in case of a blocked tube? See, the most important thing is, if the tube is if the tube is mildly scarred, then we can reconstruct the tubes. We can get it corrected by surgery, recanalization, or fimbroplasty could be done. If the tubes are not completely blocked and there is mild scarring of the tubes, then what we can do is we can do tubal cannulization, or we can do fimbroplasty of the tubes. And if there is presence of hydrosalpinx, which means there's collection of fluids in the tubes, then we can either do clipping of the tubes or we can remove the tubes totally. Another way of treatment is IVF, or in vitro fertilization, which is done at our center, International Fertility Center. In this, what we do is, from the second day of your cycle, we start you up with medicines to produce your eggs, multiple eggs, and then on the 10th or 11th day we remove the eggs, and then we fertilize it in our lab with your husband's semen, and we make an embryo. And on the 5th day or the 3rd day of the pickup, then we transfer the embryo in the uterus. So this entire procedure can be done at IFC, which is located in Green Park Center, New Delhi. If you have any queries, then you can either call us or email us. We will be most happy to help you out. Thank you.